trio Voce, and we're colleagues from Southwestern Oklahoma State University. I'm Stacey DiPaolo, clarinet. This is Robin Griffeath, tenor voice, and on piano we have Sophie Hung. We've been researching, exploring, and performing music for this combination, and at the end of this presentation, we'll be sharing a link to a fairly comprehensive list of repertoire for clarinet, tenor, and piano, which we hope will make it easier for others to find and perform this wonderful music. Before we dive into details, we wanted to start off with this very fun piece by Timothy Hoekman, composer and professor of vocal coaching and company at Florida State University.
Mezzos and baritone are medium, and contralto and bass are low.
A tenor is the highest male vocal range, normally extending approximately from the second octave below B. Could you play that note, Sophie? Two octaves below middle C.
Yes, that would be a good approximation of the tenor range. Every vocal instrument is unique, and the pitch and dynamic range is dependent upon physiology and training. Most professional tenors present a solid two-octave range from C3 to C5. In addition to range and tessitura, music that is written well for the voice will take into consideration vowels that are flattering in specific vocal registers, and the melodic motion will reflect the agility and dynamic range of specific voice types. A composer needs to understand a singer's strengths in order to write well for voices.
I also had searched for a piece I worked on years ago that I knew was for tenor, but I saw that its published title was for clarinet, piano, and high voice. Because of this, I broadened my search not only for pieces for clarinet and tenor, but also for clarinet and high voice, or titles that simply stated clarinet and voice, or clarinet and unspecified voice. With that, we found a treasure trove of more.
Absolutely. I would add that it is important to pay attention to the texts for this high voice literature. Some texts are written from a clearly male or female perspective, while others are a little more ambiguous. As you approach this literature, take the poetry into account and make sure it fits your ensemble. Sometimes a simple substitution of a pronoun is all that is needed to broaden possibilities for the repertoire. The next two pieces we will perform, Memories of Prague and Five, are from Lori Laitman's Vedem Songs. The work was commissioned by Nina Miller and the Music of Remembrance. It tells the story of the boys of Terezin and their clandestine journal, Vedem, which is Czech for in the lead. There are about 800 pages that remain, and Peter Gintz became Vedem's only editor-in-chief at 14, and at 15 he died in Auschwitz. The Vedem Songs is a verse drama, and it incorporates six of the original Vedem poems. The texts capture the tragedy of the boys' lives as well as their humanity as they use humor to cope. Laitman's melodies conjure the voices of children and use leitmotifs to unify the score and structure the dramatic action. Four distinct versions of this work exist: the full oratorio involving children's choir, mezzo-soprano, tenor, clarinet, and piano. A version for mezzo-soprano, clarinet, and piano, a version for tenor, clarinet, and piano, and a choral song cycle for boys' choir with piano accompaniment. So I hope you enjoy Memories of Prague and Five.
Thank you. Thank you.
surely know why we like to perform as singers. It makes us feel like we're singing. We're often told to sing out when we play, and it's a great feeling. I find the clarinet blends easily and well with the tenor voice, but I'd like to get your perspective on performing with a clarinet, Dr. Griffeath. Can you tell us what it's like to perform with clarinet from a singer's perspective?
Absolutely. The tenor instrument and clarinet are ideally suited to each other for several reasons. Tenors have some significant registral transitions throughout their range, and clarinets also encounter transitions related to range, and often parallel negotiation of these registers make for a sympathetic musical partnership. The warm tone of the clarinet complements the brightness of a tenor's voice as a collaborative instrument, and dynamic balance with the tenor instrument is fairly easily achieved.
We'd like to conclude with a traditional Irish folk song. Shule Agra is the first movement of a collection arranged here again by composer Timothy Hoekman, entitled Three Irish Folk Songs. It's a simple strophic song where the beauty of the tenor voice pervades, with the clarinet complementing in a similar range.
The tenor voice and the clarinet are extremely capable at coloristic shading. This ability makes our ensemble very well suited for tackling folk music. When interpreting a piece like Shule Agra that includes so much repetition, it is imperative to use a large timbral and dynamic range. These musical shadings will keep the repetition engaging and help keep audiences focused on the text.
His hair was black, his eye was blue.
Thank you for viewing this lecture recital. We as Trio Voce would like to share with you a list of pieces which can be performed by clarinet, tenor voice, and piano. It was challenging to search out and find this repertoire, but it is out there. We invite you to click on the link shown to access the file. If you have further repertoire suggestions or questions, we welcome your input and communication. Thank you.